What's up guys, this is Ben from Life in 360, and today I'm going to show you how to create a custom Nadir for your 360 photos. And look, I know what you're thinking, Nadir? What a stupid word. Yeah, I agree. Okay, so now to explain the meaning of this stupid word. So I've taken a 360 photo here with my Theta S, as you can see, and the Nadir is the bottommost point. So here I've got my tripod, and the Nadir, whatever, the actual pronunciation of it is this bottom part here where my tripod is. And what we want to do in this tutorial is show you how to insert your logo there so it stays completely flat as you move it around and doesn't end up all skewed. This will be handy for firstly covering up that tripod because we don't want that there, but also if you do want to add a logo in if you're doing something more professional. So if you want your viewers to look around, look up, and they look down and they see your logo with your phone number or whatever, I'm going to show you how to do it. So because the nature of 360 photography is circular, everything's a circle, you're catching everything around you in a big sphere, it will probably look best if you make your logo or graphic that you want to add a circle. Then when you look down, it'll be circular instead of kind of looking jagged and kind of bigger than it needs to be. So if you're trying to insert your business logo, for example, it will be best to go into Photoshop, and then I'm going to show you how to turn your square logo into a circle. Let's do it. There's the Life in 360 logo, and it doesn't necessarily need to be Photoshop. It can be any image editing program as long as it's capable of creating a circular logo. So we'll go ahead and double click the background layer there, and then we'll hit OK. That makes it editable. Now we'll head over to the ellipse section and we'll go to our circular ellipse. And we want to draw a little circle there around the logo. This will later be our circle in our 360 image at the very bottom. Get it as circular as you can. Doesn't need to be perfect. Make it as perfect as you can. Then we'll go up to select, then inverse, which means that everything outside of the logo is now selected. Now we will simply go ahead and just erase that so we have a clear background. All right, so now it's as simple as just going File, Save As, and you want to export that as a PNG. Just give it a nice little title, and then export. All right. So the next step is to open up your internet browser. We're going to go to www.nadirpatch.com. Nadir. I don't think I'll ever get that right. And here we go, this is our secret weapon. So once you're there, you'll want to hit tripod patched. Hit that one there. And so now this is a fantastic tool that will essentially allow you to insert your 360 photo that you want to use, but also your circular logo, and it'll do all the work for you. So now we'll go up to logo, and we simply just locate our circular image, which we just created. There we go. Now we'll grab our equirectangular 360 photo, which is our palm tree photo from before, and we simply just drag it over into the equirectangular projection box, and that will automatically upload for us. So now the magic happens, it's going to combine the two. Okay, there it is. So now it's giving us the option to crop. We can make it as small or large as we like. I'm gonna make it just the size of my little Manfrotto tripod. It doesn't need to be any bigger. That's still plenty big having it at about 50% there. So that's doing a good job. And once you're happy with the size, just hit the create button up the top there. All right, there's our little preview and click download. Simple as that. And it's going to download to our desktop at full resolution. This is a beautiful thing because it exports at the full resolution of your 360 photo. So you're not losing any quality. All right, there it's downloaded. And let's just have a look at it in its purest state. And there, it's done a nice job at stretching out the logo. I mean, look, it looks hideous at the moment, so don't be too alarmed. But when we bring it into our spherical viewer, I will use the Ricoh Theta viewer to have a look. There was our previous image, and we'll just drag it across there. And voila, there we have it, Life in 360. And that looks really good. See how it displays so perfectly. It's not skewed at all. When you move it, it doesn't look hideous. It looks perfect. So it's very simple and easy, and the software is free. You you don't have to pay a cent for this free online website, so take advantage of it. Personally, I actually don't do this very much. I prefer my 360 photos, when they're interactive like that, to have an untouched feel. So when the viewer looks around, there's no evidence of manipulation. However, if you're using it professionally and you do want your logo there, it's almost like having a business card in your image. So go for it. It's up to you. It's just one of many creative decisions you'll make when shooting 360. So I hope this tutorial was helpful. Feel free to send through any questions you have about anything and I'll do my best to answer them. Feel free to subscribe to us on YouTube. We're on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. I've also got a book out. It's called Life in 360, A Beginner's Guide to Tiny Planet Photography. So if you own a 360 camera, which I'm guessing you do, this is the go-to book for creating tiny planet photos and just making them really awesome and shit. So check it out. And until next time, keep living your life in 360. Talk soon.